I'm giving a lecture on the topic Homo erectus, giving emphasis to Pithecanthropus erectus. In the study of hominid evolution, three stages have been recognized. Number one, Australopithecine stage. Number two, Homo erectus stage. And number three, Homo Neanderthal stage. The period between 2 to 1.5 million years BP is considered as the reasonable point of transition from Australopithecines to Homo erectus. Various fossil remains of Australopithecines group are discovered from various parts of Africa, such as from the South Africa, from the East Africa, and also from the West Africa. Australopithecus africanus and Plesianthropus transvaliensis are discovered from the sites of Tong and Sterkfontein in South Africa. Zinzanthropus boisei and Homo habilis are also discovered from Olduvai Gorge in East Africa. And lastly, Australopithecus are also discovered from West Africa. Thereafter, the period between 1.5 million years to 125,000 years BP has been considered again as the transition stage from Homo erectus to Homo sapiens. Here again, fossil remains belonging to Homo erectus are discovered from various parts of the world, such as from Java, which is represented by Pithecanthropus erectus, from Peking, China, which is represented by Sinanthropus pekinensis, and from North Africa in Algeria, fossil remains of Homo erectus are discovered and represented by the Atlanthropus mauritanicus. Today, I will give more emphasis to Pithecanthropus erectus, and now let us try to understand about this fossil man. Various fossil remains of Pithecanthropus erectus are discovered by different scientists at different times. The Pithecanthropus erectus 1, which was discovered from the river bank of Solo River in Trinil zone of Central Java, are discovered by Dr. Eugene Dubois in the year 1890-91. The remains consist of one skull cap, three teeth, and one thigh bone. In addition to this, one lower jaw is also discovered by Eugene Dubois. The salient features of this skull cap are mentioned as: the cranial length of the skull cap is found to be 18.4 cm, while the breadth of the skull cap is 14.5 cm. As such, the cranial index is 78.80 and it falls under the mesocranial group. Mesocranial means medium skull size. Then, other salient features of this skull cap are: the vault of the skull is only 7.4 cm and it ranges from 5 to 6 cm among the anthropoid apes. In case of man, the average value of the vault of the skull is 10 cm. Therefore, with respect to this vault of the skull, Pithecanthropus erectus is in the intermediate position between anthropoid apes and man. Regarding the highest point of the skull, it lies on the point brachma. In this character also, Pithecanthropus erectus shows simian fissure rather than hominid fissure. The cranial capacity of the Pithecanthropus erectus is 914 cc according to Kite. Regarding the characteristics of the three teeth, which are discovered by Eugene Du Bois, are found to be larger than those of the hominid teeth, and roots of the teeth are also widely separated. Let us now try to understand about the characteristics of the thigh bone, which is discovered by Du Bois. The length of the thigh bone is 45.5 cm, and it suggests that Pithecanthropus erectus is within the range of 164 to 170 cm in height. Other features of the thigh bone are there is a long rough ridge, which we call as linea aspera, which is present at the posterior aspect of the thigh bone. This linea aspera affords attachment for extensor muscles. It is also present in all the modern men, and it is one of the characteristics of the thigh bone. Another important feature of the thigh bone of Eugene Du Bois is the position of popliceal surface. It is also present at the posterior aspect of the thigh bone, somewhat above the knee joint. And this popliceal surface, it is also one of the salient features which is present among the modern men. Other fossil remains of Pithecanthropus erectus are also discovered by another scientist called von Koningswald in the year 1936 and 1937 at a place called Sangiram, somewhat north to Solo River in Java. The fossil remains consist of one skull cave and one lower jaw, which is known as Pithecanthropus II. And regarding the characteristics of the skull cave, the cranial length is only 18 cm, while the cranial breadth is 14 cm, as such, the cranial index is 77.77, and it falls under the mesocranial group, even though the second skull cave of von Koningswald is somewhat smaller in terms of cranial length and cranial breadth, and also in terms of cranial index, more or less the two skulls show similarity in structure. The vault of the skull in the Pithecanthropus II is somewhat lower than the former one, and the highest point of the vault is also found at the point brachma, which is simian character, and in the latter case, the cranial capacity is found to be only 750 cc. The same scientist, von Koningswald, also discovered another mandible. You might have heard about the term mandible. This mandible, it is the largest and strongest bone of the face, and the lower set of teeth is fixed here. Regarding the mandible, which is discovered by von Koningswald, the mandible is massive in size, but the size of the canine is somewhat small and not projected forward. With regard to the size of the two premolar, it is found that the second premolar is larger than the first premolar. It is also one of the simian character which is not approached towards men. Regarding the three molars, the size of the three molars increase from the first molar, then to the second molar, then to the third molar. And the number of cups is 5 in the first molar, and number of cups is 6 in the second molar. It is also contrary to men because the number of calves is never six in the case of human being. In the year 1938 again, von Königswall discovered some fragmentary skull which consists of only the parietal bone. No full descriptions could be drawn from such fragmentary skulls of parietal bone. However, some elevated portions are found along the mid-sagittal line. Thereafter, von Königswall, with great effort, again discovered in the year 1939 fossil remains of Pithecanthropus erectus. It consists of some fragmentary skulls and one maxilla from a place, Sangiram, somewhat north to Solo River. Regarding the salient features of the maxilla, it consists of two halves, one at the right half and one at the left half. Regarding the dentition pattern which is present in this maxilla bone of von Königswall, the two premolar teeth are not of equal size, as in the case of lower set of teeth in the mandible B of von Königswall, the second premolar is found to be larger than the first premolar. In the case of three molar teeth also, size increases from the first molar to the third molar. From the mandible B of von Königswall and from the maxilla of von Königswall, which are discovered at different times, similar features of the dentition of the upper and the lower set of teeth are more or less equal in the arrangement of the premolar teeth and also in the size and the structure of the molar teeth. Thus, the Pithecanthropus erectus shows a blending of characteristics. Some characteristics shows towards the hominid characters, especially from the thigh bone, and some characteristics are towards the apes, especially from the dentition pattern of the mandible and also from the maxilla bone. You know, in the Homo erectus group, other fossil finds such as Sinanthropus pekinensis and Atlanthropus mauritanicus also included. Therefore, it is better to make a comparative study between the Sinanthropus pekinensis and Pithecanthropus erectus. The term Sinanthropus pekinensis means the Chinese man of Peking, because this Sinanthropus pekinensis is discovered from a place called Sokokdin in Peking, China. Regarding the salient characteristics of the two skulls of Pithecanthropus erectus and Sinanthropus pekinensis, in the Pithecanthropus erectus, the cranial length is 18.4 cm and the cranial breadth is 14.5 cm and the cranial index is 78.80 and it falls under mesocranial group. In case of Sinanthropus pekinensis, the cranial length is 19.4 cm and the average cranial breadth is only 14 cm. The cranial index is 72.16 and it falls under dolichocranial group. The vault of the skull in Pithecanthropus erectus is only 7.4 cm and in case of Sinanthropus, it is 11.5 cm. Therefore, the vault of the skull in case of Sinanthropus is very high in compared with the vault of the skull in Pithecanthropus erectus. In Pithecanthropus erectus, the supraorbital torus runs across the frontal bone. It is same as in the case of Sinanthropus pekinensis. The parietal bone in Pithecanthropus erectus is flattened and it is almost same as in the case of Sinanthropus pekinensis. In both cases, no sinews are found and the palate is smooth. In the case of Pithecanthropus erectus, it is a simian character because the palate is smooth among the anthropoid apes. And in case of Sinanthropus, the palate is rough. This is one of the hominid character because the human palate is rough. The size of the canine in case of Pithecanthropus erectus is somewhat small, but it is larger in the case of Sinanthropus pekinensis. There is a small gap called diastema in Pithecanthropus erectus in the dental series, but such a diastema is not found in the case of Sinanthropus pekinensis. But both the mandibles of Pithecanthropus erectus and Sinanthropus pekinensis are almost massive. The size of the molar teeth increase from the first to the third molar. But in the case of Sinanthropus pekinensis, all the three molars show similar with one another in size. The cranial capacity in Pithecanthropus erectus is 914 cc, but in the case of Sinanthropus pekinensis, it is 1075 cc. From this comparative study, we know that Sinanthropus pekinensis has somewhat longer in cranial length, and also it has more larger cranial capacity than the Pithecanthropus erectus. The Sinanthropus pekinensis skull is also thicker than the Pithecanthropus skull. Now, let us come to Pithecanthropus erectus again. The Pithecanthropus erectus was considered as an erect ape man. The literal meaning of the Pithecanthropus erectus means Pithec means ape and Anthropos means man. The Pithecanthropus erectus was considered as an erect ape man according to Eugene Du Bois. It is considered as a missing link between ape and man. But according to von Koenigswald, it is considered as a gigantic ape. However, many scientists, after detailed study of this Pithecanthropus erectus fossil finds, supported to the view of Eugene Du Bois, that is, Pithecanthropus erectus is an erect ape man. This fossil man, whose hands were free from locomotion, possessed some sort of communication system, which is more advanced than anthropoid apes and less advanced than human beings. The economic pattern of this Pithecanthropus erectus is hunting and gathering. This kind of economic pattern is believed to be handed down from the Homo habilis, who is an Australopithecine group. This Homo habilis expanded their range of habitats to different parts of the old world. The fossil remains of Homo erectus, such as Pithecanthropus erectus, Sinanthropus pekinensis, and Atlanthropus mauritanicus, which is discovered in the different parts of the world, such as Java, China, and North Africa, were considered to be the descendants of Australopithecines group. The next stage of hominid evolution is represented by the Homo Neanderthals.